सब्सक्राइब कीजिए धे आईएस चैनल को और बेल आइकन को दबाइए लेटेस्ट वीडियो सबसे पहले देखने के लिए।
Recently, the Union Cabinet has approved an order to amend the Essential Commodities Act 1955. This step is taken to deregulate commodities such as cereals, pulses, oil seeds, edible oils, onion and potatoes. This move is expected to transform the farm sector and help raise the farmers' income. The order, once if approved by the President of India and notified in the Gazette, will become law. Not only this, the Cabinet has also approved the Farming Produce, Trade and Commerce, Promotion and Facilitation Ordinance 2020. This will help in ensuring barrier-free trade in agriculture produce, creating an ecosystem for farmers and traders to purchase and sell agri-produce with full freedom. In today's edition of our DNS, we will talk about essential commodities and the amendments made in it. Let us first know what is an essential commodity. There is no specific definition of essential commodities in the Essential Commodities Act. Section 2A of the Act states that an essential commodity means a commodity specified in the schedule of this Act. The Act gives powers to the central government to add or remove a commodity in the schedule. The center is eligible to notify an item as essential in consultation with the state governments. At present, the schedule contains 9 commodities: drugs, fertilizers, whether inorganic, organic or mixed, foodstuffs, including edible oils, hank yarn made wholly from cotton, petroleum and petroleum products, raw jute and jute textiles, seeds of food crops and seed of fruits and vegetables, seeds of cattle fodder, jute seed, cotton seed, face mask and hand sanitizers. The latest item added to this schedule are face mask and hand sanitizers, which were declared essential commodities with effect from March 13, 2020 in the wake of COVID-19 outbreak. By declaring a commodity as essential, the government can control the production, supply and distribution of that commodity and impose a stock limit. As per the sources at the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, the ordinance has introduced a new subsection 1A in the Section 3 of the Essentials Commodity Act 1955. The amended law provides a mechanism for the regulation of agricultural foodstuffs, namely cereals, pulses, oil seeds, edible oils, potatoes, and supplies under extraordinary circumstances, which include extraordinary price rise, war, famine, and natural calamity of a severe nature. Under the amended Essential Commodity Act, agri-foodstuffs can only be regulated under extraordinary circumstances such as war, famine, extraordinary price rise, and natural calamity. However, any action on imposing stock limits will be based on the price trigger. As per the officials, an exemption from stock holding limits will be provided to processors and value chain participants of any agricultural produce and orders relating to the public distribution system. Talking about the history of this act, the Essential Commodities Act was legislated at a time when the country was facing scarcity of foodstuffs due to persistent abysmal levels of food grains and production. Talking about the history of this act, the Essential Commodities Act was legislated at a time when the country was facing scarcity of foodstuffs due to persistent abysmal levels of food grains production. The country was dependent on imports and assistance to feed the population. In this scenario, to stop the hoarding and black marketing of foodstuffs, the Essential Commodities Act was enacted in 1955. But the present situation is very different. In a note prepared by the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, it shows that production of wheat has increased by 10 times during the same period. The production of rice has also increased more than 4 times, from around 25 million tons to 110 million tons. The production of pulses has also increased by 2.5 times from 10 million tons to 25 million tons. In fact, India has now become an exporter of several agricultural products, With these developments, the Essential Commodities Act has been outdated. For the present times and to tackle the problems of the present days, food issues and amendments are required in this act.